factoring trinomials of type ax squared plus bx plus c, a la Shmoop. Farmer Jen Eddicks produces donut-shaped watermelons. Like Godzilla, they're huge in Japan. There's just one problem. Tossing the spoiled watermelons into the ocean has had some undesirable effects. The guy in accounting says that the amount of spoilage, or S, for producing W, number of watermelons per day, can be approximated by the formula S equals 6W squared plus 13W plus 2. What daily production level will give Jen zero spoilage? This looks like a trinomial equation of the type ax squared plus bx plus c. Here we're using w's instead of x's. To find the answer, we're going to need to factor out the a and the c in the equation. We'll do this by using a table. Our table has four columns. The first involves our a term, 6w squared. There are two possible ways to factor 6w squared. Use 3w and 2w, and 6w and w. The second column factors our c term, 2. The only possible factors are 2 and 1. The third and fourth columns use the previous two columns to decipher possible b terms. Combinations of the a term and c term factors are combined in the possible binomial factors column. If we take a look at the first row of the first two columns, our possible binomial factors come out to 3w plus 2 times 2w plus 1 and 3w plus 1 times 2w plus 2. Note the parentheses. For the second row, we get 6w plus 2 times w plus 1 and 6w plus 1 times w plus 2. Again, note the parentheses. Then the sum of the inner and outer products are used to calculate what the B term for that product would be. So, for quantity 3w plus 2 times quantity 2w plus 1, we take the outer product first, which is 3w times 1, and add it to the inner products, 2w times 2. 3w times 1 is 3w, and 2w times 2 is 4w. So the sum is 7w, not the right B term, so we keep trying. The next possible binomial factor is 3w plus 1 times 2w plus 2. Here we repeat the steps to solve for B. Nope, that one didn't work either. On to the next factors. Let's try 6w plus 2 times w plus 1. Looks like these factors don't work as well, but don't give up just yet. We still need to try 6w plus 1 times w plus 2. After doing all the calculations, we can see that the factors 6w plus 2 and w plus 2 give us our correct B term, 13w, hiding out like a bunny at a fox convention. Our work can be checked using FOIL, multiplying out the first terms, outer terms, inner terms, and last terms. We add them together and check to see that they equal our original trinomial. Yep. We pass the checkpoint, which means when spoilage equals zero, one of our factors must also equal zero. When we set each factor to zero and solve for W, we see that there is zero spoilage when our daily watermelon production equals negative 1/6 and negative 2. Since it's impossible to have negative production, looks like Farmer Jen has no choice but to introduce spoiled watermelons into the food supply. Good luck, everyone.